I'm so tired. I want to go to bed. But I got a log now for the fire. So that's cool. Welcome to Rumble Book Club. I'm your host, Michael Hernandez, and this is the show where a normal guy like me can talk about interesting books I've read, old and new, good and bad. So if you like the show, you like the content, you like the books that I talk about, or maybe you just haven't had enough sleep either, well, you've come to the right place, my friend. You can follow me on Twitter, TikTok, and Parler, or you can subscribe right down below on YouTube and Rumble. But more importantly, be a part of the conversation. Comment on the videos. Let me know if there's any books you want me to read. Let me know if there's anything more you want to see in the show. And I might even give you a shout out for, giving me a bright idea. Starting off, we're going to take a look at actually one of the Rumble comments here. Japan John, cool name. Japan John says, cool idea for a channel. You should read Incident at 20 Mile by Trevanian. It's a historical recreation of a 19th century mining town that was taken over by thieves, and the people who lived through the event fought back. Taken from newspaper accounts and executed by a very underrated American author, Eager Sanction being Trevanian's only well-known hit. That actually sounds like a really good idea. I've gotten a handful of book suggestions. I remember I got a Dean Koontz book suggestion called The Bad Place. I actually, whoever suggested me that book, I did get the book. So it's actually on my shelf. I look forward to reading it. It's one of the next books I plan on reading. But as you can see, I've got a pretty full shelf. But that one actually does sound really interesting. I'll have to, peruse Barnes & Noble shelves and see if I can find it. If not, do what I always suggest in my videos and go on Amazon. Today we're going to take a look at a really awesome book that I actually just finished. It took me a really long time to read. Today we're going to take a look at Washington, A Life by Ron Chernow. So Ron Chernow is a Pulitzer Prize winner. He's written several other really good historical pieces. One of them was actually a new bestseller that came out semi-recently called, I think it's on the shelf here, called Grant, about the life of Ulysses S. Grant, Civil War hero, and another president of the United States. This book in particular is probably the fullest and most thoroughly honest depiction of our first president and founding father, George Washington. Ron Chernow really parses through all the facts, all the fiction, and really fleshes out this full picture of the man, and you see how the legend was built. But he doesn't sanctify Washington. He doesn't make him out to be anything more than what he actually was. You really see the full picture of him. So let's get into our three-part criteria of the book, starting with the aesthetics, how it looks, how it feels, how it pops off the shelf, then getting into the readability, how it reads, not just mentally, if it's mentally exhausting or mentally easy to read, but also physically. Are the pages, really high and tight? Are the paragraphs really, really close together? Is it easy on the eyes as well as on the mind? And then finally, we'll get into the content, what information or story you're actually getting between the two covers. All right, so taking a look at the aesthetics, very beautiful cover, I think. You see the portrait of Washington during his service in the Revolutionary War. Very, very regal picture. You see him. He was known for being very fond of thoroughbred horses. He loved the kind of the white and cream-colored horses. You'd see him ride into a lot of the towns when he was traveling. Even if he was on a carriage, he knew that there was a certain expectation of his image that people wanted to see, especially after his status as a Revolutionary War hero. And so he would actually pause outside the town, get onto his beautiful white steed, and ride into the town where people would just absolutely lose their minds. So this really, you get that sense of what the public saw in Washington. But you also see he wasn't made to be overly handsome. He was a very, very plain looking man, although strong, although athletic. And you really get that from the aesthetics. So again, really regal. The text is very simple. No fat as far as the words that are added onto here. So simple gold cover where you see descriptions and praise for the book. Mine's a little worn. It's been in my bag, so it's a little scuffed. But nonetheless, as far as the aesthetics go, I think perfect score, 10 out of 10. Now let's look at the readability. It took me over a month and a half to read this, but considering how dense the information is, you're getting over 800 pages of information. It's an insane amount. Considering how much that is, Chernow writes very accessibly. Even a novice of historical works like myself, I don't spend all my time reading historical works. It's actually something I'm trying to get into. And I found this surprisingly accessible, even to a dummy like me. So good job to Chernow being able to cater to not just historians and people that love these kind of works, but people that are just trying to get into the practice. And he bounces around in Washington's timeline, but he does it by topic. So for example, he talks about a lot of the problems and issues Washington had with his teeth. And so it kind of goes back and forth at one point. So he lays out, some of the earliest days when because he started having teeth problems very early, despite the fact that he did take care of his teeth like any other person of the day. And then he zooms all the way towards the end of his life. And you get all that within a couple pages. And he just kind of threw that in there, but he goes by topic. So it makes it seem like it's a very seamless process in you learning about his life. You get the impression that you're just sitting down in a living room talking to a historian about Washington's life instead of reading something he wrote. So as far as physically, on a small note, I love when the pages are kind of staggered like this. They're not all uniform when it's given. It's a unique look. It's a small thing, but I love it. But anyway, you have very clear text. It is somewhat small, but it's clear. And that's really the important part for me. It's clear, it's easy to read, and it's against cream-colored pages with decent-sized margins. So as far as the readability goes, I think mentally and physically, it's a perfect score, 10 out of 10. So let's get into the content. This is everything you could ever wanted to know about our first president and founding father, and then some. What Chernow underscores in this book is that Washington was just a normal man. He was just as prone to error, moral shortcomings, insecurity, and ambition as any other man in his time and ours. And I think that's what made him such a legend, was that he did act in such an impeccable manner and walked such a fine line of moral fortitude and self-restraint as a normal person like this. There weren't attributes about him that were over the top. So he wasn't some superhuman in political skill. He wasn't nearly as intelligent as a lot of his peers in the revolution, such as James Madison and Thomas Jefferson. And as far as his physical strength, he was actually a relatively physically imposing guy, standing at 6 feet. Having pretty powerful muscles, but he wasn't like this Adonis figure. The fact that he was able to build this legend off just a normal man is pretty cool. I think a small sampling of Chernow's writing I think gives you a good understanding of who Washington was. Chernow writes in his book, by the time of his death, Washington had poured his last ounce of passion into the creation of his country. Never a perfect man, he always had a normal quota of human frailty, including a craving for money, status, and fame. Ambitious and self-promoting in his formative years, he had remained a tight-fisted, sharp-elbowed businessman and a hard-driving slave master. Over the years, this man of deep emotions and strong opinions had learned to subordinate his personal dreams and aspirations to the service of a larger cause, evolving into a statesman with a prodigious mastery of political skills and an unwavering sense of America's future greatness. In the things that mattered most for his country, he had shown himself capable of constant growth and self-improvement. I think that paragraph is really, really reflective of the general tone that Chernow strikes in this book, and I think it's a beautiful bit of description about Washington the man. So you learn about how growing up, he actually had a pretty hard life. He lost his father at a young age, which deprived him of an education that he so desperately wanted. And you see his insecurities in his writing, in his letters, throughout the rest of his life. The fact that he encouraged, he never had sons or daughters of his own. His wife did by a previous marriage when her husband died, his wife Martha. But he never had kids of his own. But even younger family that he took under his wing, nephews, sons-in-laws, daughters-in-laws, he was always pushing education because he knew that was something he missed, and he knew that was something he felt insecure about. He was not a man that was perfect with all of his family. While he did have an amazing, loving relationship with his wife, a deep, abounding friendship that people spoke about through all of his life and then some, he was not above conflicts with his mother. His mother raised him on her own. Again, his dad died when he was young. And his mother, God lover, managed to keep the farm, but they had a very icy relationship. At one point during the war, even though Washington sent her money, apparently she griped that it wasn't enough, and at one point even made an appeal to Congress during the Revolutionary War to get more money, which he was highly embarrassed about and griped about in his personal letters. One thing that Chernow writes about and really emphasizes throughout the book was Washington wasn't a perfect man when it came to race. He did own slaves for the entirety of his life. But when it came to his integrity to the cause of freedom, what you see is the development of a normal man of his time over the years of his life. So you start seeing him as they're discussing these broad topics of freedom, of liberty, of God-given rights. You start to see him struggle with reconciling that belief of freedom with the fact that he owned slaves and what to do about them. And it began to be a bigger and bigger problem that was occupying more and more of his mind, to the point where upon Washington's death, he did something that no other man of his revolutionary time had really done. And that was, he essentially put his money where his mouth was at the end of his life. In his will, he specifically wrote that upon his wife's death, he wanted his slaves to be freed. He essentially wrote into his will, and I guess by default, upon his wife's death, the freedom of his slaves, which was something that even great visionary, great luminaries of the time that had also paid some lip service to the freedom of black slaves, such as Jefferson, such as Madison, such as other individuals of the time, Hamilton, the Marquis de Lafayette. This was a man that actually went that step further. Now, while from our perspective in this time, we do think that is a small step, like, why didn't you do that when you were a young man, when you were first starting to hear the earliest whispers of the abolitionist movement? What you have to understand was the times that he grew up in. And Chernow does a really good job of rectifying those two, of getting you to understand that he did have, that was still, regardless, a moral failing of Washington. But you do see the moral failings of a man in his younger years, and you see him rise to the moment of his death to become something more, which was a man that was willing to see a future for black men and women in America. I honestly can't heap enough praise on this book as far as the content goes. I'm someone that doesn't like breaking rules, so I'm not going to give it higher than a 10, but just let you know, if I wasn't such a stickler about it, I would rate it a perfect score, 10 out of 10. This is a incredible book. I learned so much about our first president. I learned so much about the man, the myth, the legend, Washington, the man, Washington, the farmer, Washington, the general, and Washington, the president. It's a great book, and Washington does have the capacity for every American to read about his life and see a role model from time without seeing him as being above just a simple human being. So, Chernow, thank you for writing this piece. It is absolutely amazing. Go out and get yourself a copy. I found this at a local store in Houston called Quarter Price Books. If you're a Houston area listener or Houston area watcher, go down to the shop. You'll find some great books there. Otherwise, you'll probably be able to find it at your local Barnes & Noble, or if not, check out Price Books or your other local bookstores. If all else fails, go to Amazon online, go pick up a copy. The book is Washington, A Life by Ron Chernow. Go out and get yourself a copy. Thanks for watching, everybody, and go read something.